Okay, this is a replay of the show in its entirety called The Jew and Debbie Have a Fight and Mr. Midnight Movie and Jewish Producer Are to Blame. In its entirety. Okay?
IP addresses, and it says Jose John California's.
I see that. No,
right by the Guadalupe Freeway.
Guadalupe Freeway is brought to you by the people who build the roads that are very good, with a lot of government cheese given out on each expressway entrance or exit.
Jose, what, Cisco? We've got road to build in San Jose. It's right by Guadalupe Freeway. Get out the ukulele, sing a song for the mama. Okay, Jose. Okay, Cisco. Mama, I'm building the roads in America. I want to come home and eat tamales on your porch. And when I'm coming home, please tell Maria that tomorrow night the base are going to scorch, just like Geddy Lee slapping
that bass.
That's right. Brought to you by those good people at the Debbie Daily Network.
That's right. This song, by the way, is downloadable on iTunes. If you go right now, you can get a copy of it.
Yeah, it's called When I'm...
GuadalupeExpressway.com.
What about the Guadalupe Blues?
Ooh, we should write a song right now. We should do that. We
All
should
right.
be creative.
Let me get the slapping that bass back up here. All right, ready? I got the Guadalupe Blues. I'm on the highway. I gotta build a road. Either that or I'm gonna go back home to Mexico. Eat tamales on the front porch with my mama. Tell Maria I'm coming home soon. Take it to Steve.
I want to run away, but I don't have a place to go.
Singing this song.
Everybody wants me, but I don't know.
That's so beautiful.
So I'm going to buy a camel. And I'm going to run away.
Oh, Stevie, so good.
I'm going to go on this show called Debbie Delay.
That's a very pretty.
Shut up.
I had dead air. Now I've got a live air.
I like live air. It's so much more lively.
Guess what I got today?
What'd you get?
A brand new iPhone 5S.
Did you really?
Yeah, in the box and everything. It's the silver one. It is so beautiful.
I'm sitting here looking at I opened it up and got everything out of the box except for the earphones and the charger and stuff. The box is so pretty.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen one of these boxes?
I've seen a lot of boxes in my life, Debbie, but that's personal.
Well, this is gorgeous. I'm telling you, these iPhones, everything that Apple makes is just so gorgeous, you know?
Yeah, I got the new Samsung S5. So
yeah?
That's funny that you got that and I got the new Galaxy, so I thought that was kind of cool.
You know what I like most about this thing?
What?
I like the fact that nobody can do this except unless you have my thumbprint.
Yes. That's
Isn't that
cool.
neat? What does that say?
Okay, here's what I will do because it's a long show like they all are. And, of course, it's all my idea that they're a long show. Now we know that. Oh, wait a minute. I have to pitch my voice. Hold on. There we go.
Okay, now we all know that I'm the reason that I have 5 4-3-hour shows. It's not all the other people.
Shut the fuck up. It's not all the other people on my show, right? It's not all of them talking. It wasn't Snoozy talking the other night for not only a 2-hour show, but an additional 7-hour show behind the scenes. So he didn't talk for 9 hours. No. I'm paid for by iHeartRadio. I'm paid until the year 2023, and they gave me, I can go 24 hours a day if I want to. Oh, by the way, I forgot to check. Let's all go and check where I'm at on the live now. Ready? Let's all go over to Spreaker.com and check under live now. Let's just see where I'm at. Since I obviously lie about that too. Hold on, it's opening on Safari. I love you, Joe. Shut the fuck up. I love you. Explore. Click. Oh, my back is killing me. Oh my God, my back is killing me. Uh-oh, I sound like I have the vocal fry. I have a rare form of lupus. Yes, I did, Joe. Of course I screenshotted it. I'm no fool. I keep my hand on, it's called, it's a little cute little emblem. It's not really control or alt. It's, okay, live now, hit more. Well, look who's in first place with only 3 listens so far. That's where I start out, you fucking mullets. Go check it yourself. Now, you can't include Radio Immaculata, and you can't include alternate current radio network. They've been on for 3 years. You can't include the Pete Santilli show, and you can't include, well, you might be able to include the Classic Metal radio show. So if you include classic metal, crack and country with Brenda, and Vibes Live, I'd be in the 4th place right now. Starting out, just turning on the show. Now let me explain why that happens for you mullets that don't know. When you have proven yourself to be a player here on Spreaker, they automatically shove you up into first place when you come on. But go ahead and try to get me 404. They'll go, oh, we're not going to 404. She's one of our biggest draws. Shut the fuck up. So here's what I will do. I will go forward on this show because at the very beginning of this show, I was playing a repeat that Steve and I had done. And then it starts to go live when I pick up the boys, Mr. Midnight Movie and JP. So let me find that. 17 minutes and 59 seconds in.
So you can't see the thieves.
All right, let's go forward to 23 minutes and 8 seconds in.
Into the classroom, and there she stood, and the classroom was empty, and I went over to the corner of the room where I...
That's what I'm talking about, Stephen. Let's go to 29 minutes and 8 seconds in.
Of course, he has to copy the news guy and do his news bit like he does, and then...
All right, let's go forward to... I was talking about Goofy. 36 minutes and 51 seconds in.
Adoption, that she had to give up this baby, right?
Okay, Dad already called in. Let's go back just a smidgen. Let's go back to 3508.
Scroll down, please.
Okay, they've already called in. Let's go back just a wee bit. Let's go back to 3233.
That burned away all the cancer.
I killed her lupus.
Yeah.
All right, they had just called in. Here we go. This is when it's live, all right? It's live. It aired, originally aired... I don't know when it aired. Wait a minute. Yes, I do. Hold on. Let me scroll over to the right. It originally aired November the 9th, I think. November the 8th.
Yeah.
You mean her rare form of lupus. I have a rare form of lupus.
I had not seen it before, Debbie. This is the first time I've ever seen her lupus or anybody's lupus. It was a special lupus, and I kicked its ass.
Yeah. So think that you guys are back to liking Angela again? Is that right? No.
What?
You're curing her cancers and stuff.
Well,
I sucked it out.
Ooh, gross.
Yeah, I did.
Yes, yes.
It's nasty. I'm tired tonight. That my
umbilical cord.
Yeah, we did it. We did it for her minor children.
She doesn't have any more fucking minor children. One's, I think, 21, isn't it?
45, but that doesn't make them minor.
The big oofy one that's a man now?
They should sue her.
Yeah, they should sue her. We're gonna represent her kids in a lawsuit.
They probably will one day. Luckily, they don't live with her anymore, but that's not any my business, right?
We're setting up a no-class lawsuit.
You know, no Goofy class. Spells Knightley, Nighlews. I mean, he's just pathetically stupid.
Lol. Lawl.
Lol.
He should work for the Donald Trump campaign.
Lol. Did you know that, well, I can't really say this out loud, but something really big is fixing to happen in our family that has to do with campaigning, if you know what I mean. Wink, wink, wink. Wink, wink, wink. Do, 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 do. No, it's really... What? No.
Some kind of office?
No. He's going to run for El Presidente. No, I'm joking. La di di da 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 da. It's very exciting. I will tell you, but I'm not going to say a word about it. I'm not allowed to say a word about it.
Said a word about it.
What?
Say two words about it.
No, I can't tell you any kind of details, but I will show y'all because I only trust you guys with it. Watch. Don't look at your screen real quick, and I'll show you what I'm talking about, okay? And don't say it out loud. I'm serious because the trolls would go nuts, fucking nuts. Hold on, hold on. Come here, computer. Damn it, Debbie. Boink. Okay, and hold on. It's coming. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Scroll down, please.
Beauty.
It is, well, Debbie, look right here. Hosted by blah, 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 and blah, blah, blah. Da, 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 da. What do you think about that? That's pretty cool, huh? What is next? Next. Oh, we have to select an amount. What should I put you down for?
$5 billion.
Oh. Put us down for a billion, Debbie.
Oh, Lord. But anyway, yes.
Yeah, parlay the $50,000 we're getting from Mr. Solution. Mm-hmm. Donate it to that.
And that's going to be at you know where and you know why and all that stuff. That's what I wanted to show you. Oh, I found your little sweet pea. Here's your crazy girl. Here is Ron Paul girl doing a Hare Krishna. But I think what she's doing is just showing off her new boobs that she got for Christmas.
Krishna, 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 Hare, Hare.
And she bangs her little drum. Stone cold fuck nuts. I'm telling you, just nuts. But cute.
A look of crazy.
Yeah. I have no time for crazy people in my life.
Thank you. And she does this one right here that's really nuts when she did this one right. When, you know, how much can I tell you? She, you know, she talks very open about her adoption, that she had to give up this baby, right? Mm-hmm. And what she doesn't realize is that...
Give up a baby for adoption?
Yeah.
A half Asian baby, if you know what I mean. Mushroom count loud in the bathroom.
Asian.
And here she is.
And now that it always comes back to her, and I can't keep it. I mean, look, we had so much time together. Is this even recording? We had so much time together. I know I look like a mess, but...
And this one guy says down here, he says, oh, looks like she deleted all the comments. That's weird.
But I'm responsible.
Now, she says that her boyfriend that was living with her is the one that raped her. I don't understand, but I do know that, back when she was getting trolled really hard, there was a bunch of stuff that leaked out. And one thing is that she was, maybe this is the one where all the nasty comments are.
I'm dying for my daughter, people.
No, that's not.
Just, here's her blanket and everything. And
there was things going around that she had... really scared these people, that these people tried to let her have visitation with this child and she tried to steal it. She got banned out of the hospital for going up there one time when the child was sick. Just a lot of really weird stuff went on. And
nuts.
Yeah. And I'm just really starting to realize that some people are just stone cold fuck nuts. I mean, like that Tyree Sneed, he's crazy. I mean, in fucking sane. I'm not kidding. Anyway, really weird. But and then she calls it her daughter, and she stalked these people with it, and they finally had to block her, and they changed their name and all this weird stuff to get away from her. But she calls it her daughter, and she cries and says she buys it all these things all the time, and it's weird. I don't know. It's really sad, but I don't know. Ask me why I brought up RPG. I skipped it. Mr. Midnight Movie brought her up to begin with, because the night before, Laszlo P. Quagmire had brought up the fact that she's stone cold fucking nuts. Let me tell you guys a little secret, okay? In the year 2010, when she was getting trolled very hard by Twerpington on Blogstalk Radio, she came to me and said... in a private message in my chat, she said, are you familiar with Dr. Herpington? I said, yes, I am, and you need to get away from him. Well, she gives me her cell phone number, which I still have. I called her. We talked for a while. I told her that he was dangerous to stay away from him, that he was trolling her, and he was trolling her pretty hard. In the interim, Goose came to me and said, hey, Debbie, do you think you can help this Ron Paul girl out a little bit? I said, I'll see what I can do. Called her back. Ask Goose. Called her back. I said, what is going on with you? She goes, well, these people forced me. She said, the Edna Gladney home forced me to give up my daughter, and they made me sign adoption papers while I was drugged up. I said, okay. So here's what I did. I contacted in Fort Worth, her venue for legal matters. I contacted an attorney that I knew, a family law attorney. I said, will you call this girl? He calls her. He calls me back. He says, I don't know if this girl's telling the truth, but I cannot call and verify anything. It's beyond my capacity. But you could. So I called Dr. Bida. He's a dentist. I called him and he called me back. When he called me back, I was real busy. I said, shit, I got to take this call. I'll never forget. I was at the barn. I run outside of the barn. I go, hi, let me introduce myself. My name is Debbie. I'm a podcaster. I do podcast on Block Talk Radio. He goes, oh, okay. I said, I'm calling regarding Brooke. He goes, oh, okay, Brooke. I said, Dr. Bida, is what she says the truth? And he goes,
Debbie, right? I said, yeah. And he goes, don't believe anything that Brooke says on that podcast. He said, her mother and I listened to about two of them, and no, it's not true. He said, Brooke, upon a brain scan, if you want to know the truth, here comes the truth, upon a brain scan when she was about 18, found out that there was something wrong in the part of her brain, which is some cortex frontal bullshit thing that controls fantasy. And that's where people that get their, they begin to create these things that happen. She was told at the age of 21 to never get pregnant. She was put on strict birth control pills. And while living with a guy that was Asian, his name, well, I could give you his name. She got pregnant. She did not tell her parents about it. She hid it and hid it and hid it until around some holiday, he said she came over and they knew she was pregnant. They immediately sent her to Edna Gladney, and she was told to give up the child for adoption. Okay? She didn't sign the paper. Edna Gladney Home didn't do that. They don't do that. Now, when she got her new tits, she named one Edna and one Gladney when she was showing them off on webcam to all the boys one night. But we're not going to talk about that. I said, well, so I feel like an idiot. He goes, she is... He says her mother won't even speak to her. I mean, what's got to happen that your mother doesn't speak to you? He says that she went on this podcast and all she goes on Ustream, live stream, and all these things at one time in the middle of the night with tons and tons and tons of makeup on. And he just says they basically just had to disown her, more or less. And they just basically wrote her off as, well, scratch that one. Now she's got a big sister that basically doesn't have anything else to do with her either. Well, this Jew, no, I'm live right now, Allie. This Jew starts calling into White Nighter on her show. However, there's audio out there on my show where the Jew calls me laughing at this girl. She even plays that as an intro. I made her an intro because her intro sucked. I made her the cutest intro and she played it all the time. It made her look in a very good light. Well, her main caller was Dr. Herpington. Every fucking night, Dr. Herpington. Then she would go in webcam on Tiny Chat for the BWC. And she would giggle and smidgle and all this kind of goo, 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 goo stuff. And they would pull me in there she didn't know I was in there. And they would get her IP addresses. They would do all this kind of stuff to her. They were really kind of, you know, getting to her pretty good. This was the new fags. And Twerpington really did some head games on her. You know, really did some head games on her. And he would really get her upset about stuff and she would buy into it. And she's just basically part of her brain is not there. It's not active or whatever. I don't know what happened, but anyway, that's the truth about Ron Paul girl. Okay. Now you think about this, your own father, a respected member of the Dallas community, tells me, don't believe a word she says. Then she made a website, a blog at one point that was called, you know, poor me, I lost my daughter, and all this kind of bullshit. He goes, bullshit. He goes, she didn't lose her daughter. We could not trust her to have that daughter because you never knew what she was going to do. She could say, oh, I forgot and I left it in the bathtub. She's just like that. But there is a part of her that knows what she's doing. Do you see what I'm saying? Because she goes on webcam with tons of makeup on and she flirts with all the boys. There's over 400 videos. Now, come on, guys, tell me. On one channel, she's over there crying for her daughter. And yes, it is true. Dr. Bida told me that the new parents had to go off the grid to get away from this woman. Because, yes, at first, they quasi-agreed to let Brooke see this kid sometimes. And when she came over, she would not bring it back on time. She was doing all, and then she would cry and throw a fit when she brought it back. Oh, my daughter. Well, you know, whatever. I mean, I'm not going to post my own judgment on her, but whatever. I would never tell Heather not to have a child because Heather's capable of raising a child and she's doing a very good job at that. However, the Jew always buddies up with the blondes. He did it with me. He did it with another girl named this and another. And so he buddied up with Brooke. Oh, and he was her buddy. He knew Brooke. And the way you get to Brooke is you side with her on her cause. Okay? Oh, well, you poor thing. Then she's just going to suck you dry. Well, there's plenty of archive over there of the Jew kissing her ass and blah, 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 blah. And I think he even offered to fly down to Dallas because he was going to fly his own airplane, all this bullshit. I recently spoke with her. She's even on my contact list on Twitter, and she's on my contact list on my Gmail account. But I promised Brooke I would never read those, and I won't. I won't do it. And I will say this. In my defense, it was alluded to that the Jew was stalking her. And she was like, go away. Get away. You know, you just go away. He wouldn't stop because he ignores his kid constantly to just stalk women on the internet. And here's the deal. Here's what I know to be true. Are you listening? I'll wait. When somebody knows that you've got the goods on them, a psychopath will try very hard to beat you to the punch and start to discredit you before you can sing. Before you can sing. Does that make sense? Did that go over your heads? Okay, let me reword that. If Mr. White had the goods on me of something really, really rotten, all right, and I know that he's got that, and I know that I've pissed him off, I'm going to try, if I'm a psychopath like these guys are, if I'm a psychopath, I'm going to try to beat Mr. White to the punch by saying, Mr. White's a crazy motherfucker. He's insane. Mr. White's a liar. Mr. White's nuts, because I'm trying to beat him to the punch of exposing my crap. Do you understand what I'm saying? I believe the Jew heard on that show that I had the goods on him with RPG, and so he set out to destroy me because he knows I've got the goods on him. So stick that in your Jewish pipe and smoke it, you fucking asshole. Let's go back to the show. And I don't know. Anyway, I don't know. I can't ring you in, Jew. You're on a separate line. Besides, you're just going to be mean. But
how did he act yesterday? I didn't listen to the entire show.
I don't know.
He sounded lethargic and kind of out of it.
Well, maybe a stomp.
Now, remember, Jewish producer says, I wasn't even there that night. I don't know what was said about Ron Paul girl. Really?
Stomp to the testicles might do him some well.
I don't know. He's okay. He's just kind of like a downer. You know what I mean?
Sometimes he can be a downer.
Are we on the air, or are you going on the air?
It's me, Brooke from Birth Mom Missions. I wanted to talk to you. The background's really great.
And this person says in here, oh, here it is. I think this is it. I don't know where the fuck it is. This one guy goes, you are disgusting to use the Ron Paul Lib campaign on this issue to push a political agenda. I am a closed adoption, and you are saying that adoption isn't an adoption. You are an arrogant, narrow-minded moron, and you need to close your selfish mouth. I don't know what the circumstances of being given up, but I bet you do. You need to shut your mouth and go put your head back up Ron Paul's ass where it's nice, warm, and comfortable. And there's some pretty wild, wild, wild things. Like somebody said, stop me live again. There was I forgot what I was going to tell y'all. The blog that she did in 2012, there was a post on there, and it was a pretty long post. And the girl comes on there and she says, hello, my name is blank. I went to high school with Brooke. Let me tell you something about this bitch. This bitch was not raped. This bitch is a liar. She's a whore. Everybody knew it. She was a whore in high school. And her parents finally stepped in and took control of her through the court services of Dallas County or Tarrant County. And she is lying to you, know, just went into all this shit and says, and I don't have it. I don't remember who she was, but she says, if anybody doubts me, here's my name and here's my number. And when I read that, it just backed up everything that I had assumed about this woman. Now, anyway, back to the audio. You know, you sit there with your makeup caked on, worrying about how you look. And I mean, just some really wild. Here we go. No, there's another one. It was pretty wild. Some of the stuff that people say to her. And I'm like, fuck, you know. She calls it her daughter. My daughter. My daughter. And then she tells people she was raped, but it was her boyfriend that she lived with. I mean, I don't understand that. And I don't know. Just really weird stuff. And I don't care. I just love it.
My whole soul aches for her.
Who would do this on a podcast? Oh, here's one.
Please don't.
Anybody knows that when you have no tears, I'm back live. When you have no tears and you're pushing your voice to sound like you're crying, you're not crying. You're just going like this. You're acting like you're crying. And I'm sorry. I know the game, guys. I'm one of them. I'm a girl. And I know the difference between fake crying and real crying. And on my shows, when I have tried to fight tears, really fight tears, which is what a real female will do because she doesn't want to use that against people. You pause, you try to take a breath, you wait a minute, you try to calm yourself down. You don't go like this and act like you're crying. I mean, people, come the fuck on. Are y'all those idiot guys that take that shit serious and think that that's really crying? That's not crying because you don't talk like that when you're crying. You fight it back when you're crying. But that's what somebody like me does. It's a real person. I mean, I don't give a fuck. Y'all can think what you want to think. You're just mad because I've got you. You know, I've got every one of you pegged. What show was it that I cried with about my kids? Y'all remember which one that was? I was going to show you which one, how it sounds when somebody's really crying. It was, what was it? Remember when I played that music and everybody was saying, oh, I know how I can find it. Snoozy asked me on Facebook the next day, did you cry on the show about the Jew last night? And I said, oh, you're kidding, right? Hold on. Oh, hang on just a second. I'll get back to you in just a second, David. Hold on for me. Okay, Snoozy said to me, I love you, Debbie. No, I'm joking. Hold on. I won't read a word. On November the 24th, were you crying on your show the other night? Crap, that's not good enough. The other night, so we know it was somewhere around the 24th. Let me take a look over there and see. Hold on. He asked me on the 24th. Let's see if you're up here. The 24th. I don't know which one it was. Crap. An afternoon spent with Hillary Clinton. Let's see. Here's one I had the beta cuck thing on there. Let me see if it was this one. Because you'll see what it sounds like when somebody really tries not to cry. When I play that song, remember? No, I can do it. This. Hold on. Right click and inspect element. I mean, never mind. Just didn't mean to say that. Yes, he's a child molester. But see, actually, it is
more relaxed than it is now.
No, that was when Joe called in and wore out the Jew and the news guy for being so mean to Andy Bong. So it wasn't that one. That one was when I put the news cuck thing. I mean, the beta cuck thing. Afternoon spent with Hillary. No, that was afternoon spent with Hillary. Two grown men assault a young boy and tell him lies. How did that happen? That escalated quick. I don't know. Maybe it was this one called. He said the other night. So that would be 1, 2, 3. We'll go back 4 nights. See if this was it.
Yesterday you did. You ripped on news guy. You took it down. I want to listen to it on the way up to Duluth. Business, so I don't know
who that fucking psychic was, but I want her number. He fries.
They are so good.
I know. Oh, guess who had Hillary at their house yesterday all day long? Hold on, that's not it. I'm gonna show y'all. I'm gonna take just a second to do this. Hang on, everybody. I don't remember. He asks me on the 24th, so we'll just take it that it was the night before, maybe? We'll try this one. According to a recent research, 77% of people in straight relationships still...
I made some connections. I could make some money on this.
And to me, these alpha, these beta males...
She's crazy. But that's just me, and it's...
is the difference? I mean,
well, these are the guys that don't have the ability to lead.
Oh, listen, it's Lester who wants nothing to do with me. Another lie by the Jew. Hold on, I'm looking. One more. Let me try one more. Oh, I know where we'll be quicker on iTunes. What an idiot, Debbie. Okay, let me go to his podcast. Oh, man. Yeah, Goofy, nobody bought your bullshit about me because you were actually, you actually play my shows. Nobody asked you to play that show. You worship me. Just, it's so hard to say because you're a beta cuck. It is. All right, I'll look at it this way. Okay, we'll start, he said the 24th. We'll look at the 22nd. We can go quicker this way.
You know, to make himself feel, you know, manly. And
news guy.
What?
I was singing to the news guy. It's like, ooh, girl, you're going to get in trouble. She goes, I don't know how to work it. And so she goes on her cell phone and does a, not that one. Oh, oh, oh.
Because when he was in, crap. It's a clear straw colored in appearance, and it is a hydrocarbon.
That one. Hold on. Dildos don't have...
Oh, sorry, I'll give you a link.
Love it, man. You are the greatest.
Jealousy. Let's go to the next one. Is that a banana in your pocket, or are you just happy to see me?
Government simply decided to leave behind. We destroyed the government, toppled Saddam.
My sunglasses at night, so I can. It might be this one, because Heather used to love that song. It might be this one. We'll let it play. Something. All right, the lines are open, and if you're not calling, if the phone's not ringing, I can assume you're still not calling. The area code to call is 214.
My words are a matter of pride.
Brush.
That's you too.
Damn it. We'll try this one.
The dead.
Maybe it's not such a bad idea, this position that we're in right now.
Just put Nancy Boy on IR.
It's women. I'm going to continue with what I was playing until Doodlebug calls back in.
Cage door's going to close.
I beg to differ, and in fact, I talked to Mr. Midnight Fluvies about that today. I said, let me tell you something, bitch. If you hear me cry on this podcast, it's about as real as you can get. And I said, because I know when women are fake crying. All right, it must have been before that. It must have been, not a Celtic, was it a Celtic invasion? Little Audrey said.
I'm talking about guard since I saw you last, and that was a long, interesting conversation.
Talking about came from my husband.
The trolls, I guess you could say. I'm so sick of that word. I hate. Okay. I need to get the Ninja Mouse back.
Nobody cares about me. I want to.
What? Your mouse over the title of the show. Look at your link down at the bottom.
Oh. By me, moi. The apostrophe thing.
Many times. Crap. So it must have been, it couldn't have been Andy's dance party. Maybe it was this one. Fuck. Here to tell about anybody's secrets, but I will tell my opinion, and that will usually be in my book, and if you really do your homework, the truth. David Fikert, at a very low, low level. David Fikert has just a touch.
Oh,
it's horrible.
Shit.
I don't know where it's at. Does anybody know the show that I started crying when I played the songs about Heather and Steven? You know, the ones that just tear me up? The ones that just kill me? It's the ones that are by James Taylor. Does anybody remember that? I'm down to And Now the Truth on November the 14th. I could do... I've got Celtic, and Celtic on the ones before that. And then Debbie, it just, nothing. It's just, I don't know where it's at. I'll try one more. He's trying to learn how to do some cooking and stuff. But
You know, I talked to a friend of mine today on Skype. Well, no, maybe I won't. Maybe I'll
keep this offending IP address. No, she leaves it there.
Labeled, still worthy of being a bad man.
Oh, I love that speech. Well, I don't know where, if anybody knows where it's at, send it to me on Skype, the name of it, and I'll be happy to play it. But let's go back to the show that was deleted because the Jew asked me to delete it. He asked me to take it down. I thought, okay, I'll take it down. Here we go with the Jew and Debbie have a fight, and Mr. Midnight Movie and JP are to blame, laughing out loud. Ah, it's starting all over. I can't die. I can't. I can't die. Okay, they're still watching my screen with me, and we've moved on to a different topic here with my life. My life has not been fun. It has not been a bed of roses. But as far as human emotional strength goes, I believe I am a mountain. I'll be honest with you. And I think that that comes from, you know, they say that the more a fighter fights Mr. Midnight Movie, the stronger he gets. Seriously. You
know, well, that's true in the beginning, unless he really gets rocked. And that in general, as Mr. Solution would say, that is the rule. And you know, there are exceptions to the rule, but as Mr. Solution would say, the exception proves the rule. And yeah, the better you get.
Okay, I can go forward on this and we can listen to all this boring bloviation. We talk about this cop that got shot in California, and I show him the film, and it was really kind of sad. We'll go forward. Hold on, let's get the ninja mouse. I can't die. That's the cop that got shot. Then we talk about that.
That whole thing.
That's the speech that the cop made after he was well. Let's go to 106:21. Dalton is half blind, and I was too blind. There's where I sing I'm sorry to Mr. Midnight Movie. To see. Right, boys?
Yes. Do you think we can bring on the great and wonderful Chris Nelson?
You guys go, Chris Nelson. Watching
Walking Dead like everybody else.
That's all I do is watch the fucking Walking Dead. I think that's what's making me depressed. It's really depressing.
Yeah, it is a downer.
It really
is. I never got into that show, but it is a downer.
I'm on season 3, episode 6, and I'm like, what the fuck? It's like, geez, I don't need this in my life, Goose.
Well, right now is the time slot for the live, whatever they call that, the premieres of shows, so... nobody's going to be listening to the show tonight.
I think
everybody's
it ended.
Watching
I think,
Walking Dead.
Didn't Walking Dead end the whole thing?
No, it's still going. This is, I think, the last season.
Oh, well, it'll be over soon, and they'll all be crowding through the chat rooms, I'm sure. But, yeah, I was watching that, and I'm like, oh, my God, it's so depressing. It really is. But I did get turned on from Sunny by... Sonny turned me on to, of course, now this is going to upset Goofy. There she goes, mentioning Sonny. I mean, he's just one of my fucking friends. He's an asshole. I mean, I'm sorry that he's my friend. I'll tell him not to be my friend if it's going to upset you. God damn. There she goes, talking about Sonny again. You know, look how Todd Morris, the genius, spelled. She deleted all of her context. Hey, asshole. It's D-E-L-E-T-E-E-D, you stupid idiot. Oh, I'm never going to name my shows again because they always fucking change. Go watch The Walking Dead. All right, let me show you what Sonny turned me on to, and it's really cool. It's a movie that was made, and it got released, and they pulled it from the theaters.
Okay, here's where we start talking about JFK. That's going to be boring to you guys. Let's go forward. Let's go to 1:17:25.
What are they trying to do?
You didn't read anything?
I don't follow the fucking news.
All right, well, fuck it.
I want to know. I know all about Bing.
No. They're saying that he fabricated stuff about his personal life.
Oh, horseshit. They say that I'm a coke whore, that I was a prostitute. It's just bullshit, and if you people believe it, you're idiots.
Well, I think they're thinking that I'm you, and I was a coke whore. I love Coke. When I was younger, I loved Coca-Cola.
I think it's ridiculous the way people do that shit. Leave him alone. Just realize that he has surgery in babies that are inside the womb, and he is just, you're just scared to death of him. That's all it is. Go ahead and vote on Trump. Do that. And let us get killed or something. You know what I'm saying? Fuck you people, you idiots. You know, I'm just so sick of people. People are so fucking stupid. I'm so dumb, sick and tired of idiotic fucking people that I could throw up. You know, I could just throw up. People are so fucking stupid. He's a goddamn brain surgeon is what he is. Go away. I don't want to do that. I don't know what you're trying to do to me. Go away. Fuck off. Hold on. I'm just getting out of Safari. You will not beat me, Safari. Thank you. Goodbye. Now we'll do a force quit and we'll make you quit. Watch this. You'll quit. Oh, yeah. You'll quit. Force quit. Bye, Safari. Anyway, so much for that idea. But it's a good movie, and it tells exactly the way... Maybe it's going to play on this one. It goes down exactly the way it went down, as far as every single thing that happened. I mean, it's my new... I mean, I could have...
In each administration, the brothers who are not president would take over the most powerful cabinet.
This is the most richest man. He plays the part of Clint Murchison. They need... Most richest man. What does that even mean, Debbie? Let's go forward. We'll go forward. We're talking about JFK. Let's go to 129.29.
Hi.
We're still on JFK. Let's go to 137.31.
It's Marine Corps.
Let's go to 143.33. Okay, stop. The Jew had already pissed me off at this point, and I decided I was going to rage quit. And then I said, wait a minute, what the fuck? I'm sorry, Sonny. I have to do it.
It's Marine Corps.
We're going to let's start here.
Attended Aviation Fundamental School.
See, on iTunes, it only lets you jump certain places, and it's making me jump to 137.35, so we're going to have to take it from here, boys.
Naval Air Station in Jacksonville, Florida, studying basic radar theory, map reading, and air traffic control procedures. Began studying Russian language and taking pro-communist attitudes.
This is actually kind of interesting. This shows you how they set up Oswald as the patsy.
Fellow Marines called him Oswaldovich and Rusky.
In the Marine Corps? Not a chance. I'm preparing a cover for him.
Naval intelligence?
Either that or CIA.
Go ahead, Tim.
And the government had this movie pulled out of theaters. It was released in, what was it? 90, no, it was released in 70. This is me live. Released somewhere in 70-something. And it was only out for a week until some of the people went and saw it, and they had it pulled out of the theaters. Isn't that great? Did you notice that line? He said, in the Marine Corps? Never. They're preparing him for cover. And the one guy goes, Naval intelligence? And he was like, or operative, CIA operative. And then it just goes and goes and goes. And I'm telling you guys, this is the film to watch if you want to know what really happened. More so than even the film JFK. JFK focused a lot on what happened down in New Orleans because that's where a lot of it went on. And Garrison, the DA down there, actually, damn it. Garrison, the DA down there, actually, they had a trial and stuff. Now, I hope you're wanting to talk about JFK. Hello. What's up?
Have the decency to pull this show when you're done with it. Or clean it up.
What do you mean?
You know exactly what I mean. Remove that stuff with Brooke in it.
Oh, please. Give me a break.
Not please. What has she done to you? Anything?
I didn't say she'd done a thing. I said she's sweet.
So then why were you dissecting and whatever on
there? Why would you dissect Mr. Solution?
That's a different thing.
No,
he's
it's
a
not.
Figure that came on. So, you want to go at me with this.
Okay.
I will wash my...
Bye. Get lost. Fuck you. Don't talk to me like that. Nobody fucking talks to me like that. I'm fucking Debbie Daly. You don't fucking talk to me like that. Who the fuck do you think you are? You don't tell me what to do. Fuck you. Come at me like that and threaten me. I'll toss you right off this fucking show. Block me again on Skype. You don't threaten me. You don't know anything about me and Brooke. We live in the same town. You don't know anything. You just come on with threats. And then you fucking run somebody that I happen to care a lot about off of my show because of your mouth. So go in my chat room and start talking about me again. Go run back over to Bathtub Girl and start telling her shit again. I don't give a fuck. Nobody talks to me like that, Jew. Nobody. Unless I earned it. And I don't earn anything like that with you. Ever. Period. Come in here and talk to me like that. Fuck that. Fuck that. I mean, I'm like, what the fuck do you think you're talking to? I'm not one of your little bitch girls. You don't even know what I was talking about. You don't even know. I was saying she's sweet, she's precious, but there is something not right. Because Laszlo knows her in real life, Jew. Like you said the other night, do your fucking research and don't ever fucking call up and jump my ass again. Jesus Christ. As much shit as I put up with you, I don't think I would do that. I really don't. I don't give a fuck. I don't need anybody on this show. Anybody. I don't kiss anybody's fucking ass. Well, thanks to the Jew, I'm not going to do this anymore tonight. I'm too bad of a mood now. I'm not in a bad mood. I'm just tired. I don't feel like fucking with it. You know what I mean? I mean, everything's fine in my personal life. I'm not over here fighting or anything like that. In fact, we've had some really good news lately. But I'm just kind of fed up with it, you know? Fed up with the asshole. Oops, hold on. I got a call. Hey, Goose.
Funny cat. Doing funny human thing. Oh, wait. Deb, what's going on?
Not much.
I was watching funny videos with cats.
Oh, I love those. Hey, do this. Google.
Funny human things. Look at them go.
No. Google parrots with cats.
Okay. So, did you send the email?
Not yet. I'm on my show.
Debbie, all right. Well, let's do this. Let's make a show out of this.
You want to?
No. Let's not talk about what we're doing.
No.
Let's send the thing. Send me the screen cap.
All right.
Can we do that now?
Yeah, we can do it right now. Hold on just a second. Let me go and get into
it. Let's not talk about what we're doing.
I'm not. Let me go to...
People are going to ask questions, and you're not going to answer them.
That's right. I'm going to show you.
This is all about Spreaker stuff, right? This is all about Guy Shay. We're sending a report to Spreaker about Guy Shay. That's what we're doing right now. Right, Deb?
Yes, we are.
Spreaker.
All right, wait a minute. I still haven't heard anything. No, nothing.
She didn't send anything.
I'm looking. Wait a minute. I'm not going to say a fucking word. Let me screen share with you. Are you at home or at work?
I'm at home.
Are you on your phone or on your computer?
I'm on my computer.
Okay, what's your screen then on Skype?
We don't talk about this on air.
Look what it says right here. Wait a minute.
Yeah, but that's some like error message.
Mailer demon. Hold on just a second. What does it say? Hold on.
Debbie, did you make up this email address?
Did I do what? Did I what? Failure notice. Maybe I did it wrong. Let's try another one. Hold on.
Wait, did you?
Did I what?
The correct, you just responded to the right address, right?
I know I did. I can try one more time.
Wait. Can you show me the original email she sent?
Hold on just a second. Is this it? Is this inbox? Let me go to inbox. Inbox. Okay.
This just seems a little suspect now.
Let's research this right here. Let's research her name. But I know it was her. I mean, look at this. She even gives your exact thing.
Well, why? Yeah, but hold on. But you're on a show right now.
Right.
I don't want to get into this. But this person knows your Twitter, right? So you guys have talked through Twitter before.
No, I've never spoke to her on Twitter. Never.
How does she know your email address?
Because anybody can figure that out. It's all over the fucking internet. And I don't even use this goddamn...
How did she know your email address? I just need to know that. Like, you don't gotta hide stuff. I don't care. Listen, I don't care. I just want to know how. So I can determine whether or not this is legit. Because I really do need to know if this is legit. Because, like, why would they come to you if it wasn't legit? Like, and why buy
I
that
told
email
you
address?
What I told you what I think. You want me to play something real quick so I can talk to you for just a second? Hold on. Let me put
No. Yeah, can you do that?
I can do that. Hold on. I'm going to put on a song real quick and talk to Goose for just a second. And that way y'all can't hear us. And I'll just put on... I'll put on Angela's song, Angie Baby. We'll be right back in...
Put on a long song. Put on, like, Ride of the Valkyries.
The long version of Led Zeppelin's Stairway to Heaven. We'll be right back.
You live your life in the songs you hear on the rock and roll radio. And when a young girl doesn't have any friends, that's a really nice place to go. Folks hoping you'd turn out cool, but they had to take you out of school. You're a little touch, you know, Angie baby. Lovers appear in your room each night and they whirl you across the floor. But they always seem to fade away when your daddy taps on your door. Angie girl, are you all right?
And said, say a prayer for me. She threw her arms around him, whispered, God will keep us free. They could hear the riders coming. He said, this is my last fight. If they take me back to Texas, they won't take me back alive. There were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. They were praying for the lovers in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. And seven Spanish angels took another angel home.
She reached down and picked a gun up that lay smoking in his hand. She said, "Father, please forgive me. I can't make it without my man." And she knew the gun was empty, and she knew she couldn't win. But her final prayer was answered when the rifles fired again. There were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. They were praying for the lover in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. And seven Spanish angels took another angel home.
There were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. They were praying for the lover in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. Seven Spanish angels took another angel home. All right, y'all, help me now.
There were seven Spanish angels
at the altar,
of the sun.
Oh, I believe
they were praying for the lover
that it was
in the valley of the gun.
Well.
When the battle stopped and smoke cleared,
there was thunder
on the throne.
Oh, yeah.
And seven Spanish angels took another angel
I'm back. Hold on. Stop. I'm back. I'm sorry for the clusterfuck. Because I'm going to go do it right now. Shut up. Go away. I'm not taking your call right now, sweetie. I'm doing it right now. Hang up. We're on the air. I got to go. No, don't say anything. Don't say anything. Don't say anything. I'm going to screenshot it and send it to you. Hang up. Okay. All right. Fuck. Hello, Andy. What's up, Buttercup? Yes, we can do a show. Yes. We can. Pumpkin. Andy wants to do a show. I've got so many messages on Skype. I'm just going to ignore them for right now, if y'all don't mind. I'd rather get back to doing this because I want to get it over with. I've got people waiting on me. I've got money to count. Hold on, Andy Bong. Let me get through with this pee-pee and then we'll do a quick show. Hold on, sweet pea. I've got the door downstairs deadbolted and it's the inside deadbolt where nobody has a key and I'm scared to death that Victor's going to come to the door and he's going to get pissed off because he can't get in. So I need to put this on, let it run. I've got to do a tweet. I've got to do a direct message. I've got to do some screen caps because I've got some people waiting on stuff. So I'm doing this bullshit for the fucking dumbass people. So here we go. Back to this. And now.
Damn, I'm not some fucking bathtub girl bitch or desert rose. Fuck off. Ugh.
If you had not have fallen, then I would not have found you. Angel flying too close to the ground. And I patched up your broken wing. Hung around a while, trying to keep your spirits up.
Andy, wait on. Hi, baby. What you doing, pumpkin?
Hey, how are you doing, Debbie? Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, I can, smiley face.
What's up? What's up? What's up?
You look so cute. I'm doing a show right now to show something that they wanted me to. The news guy wanted me to play some audio. So let me finish playing this audio, and then we'll bust a rhyme.
Okay. Take
here's, it here's what I want you to do. While we're waiting, I want you to give me the names of the songs that you want me to play on the show.
Okay. Shut up and dance with me.
Not right now. I want you to write them in the chat room on Skype. Can you do that for me, Pumpkin?
Sure, we can do that. I can do that right now.
All right, I'm going to hang up because I'm going to finish the show that I'm on right now, and then I'm going to come back. All right?
Okay.
All right. And you'll feel it down. In case you're always wondering why I always play this song, okay, you got me, Lord guy. All right, fine. Fuck them and let them eat fish. All right. Fuck them and let them eat fish. I don't fucking like. Shut up! Stop telling what to do. I've got some stuff to do. I love you all. I didn't lie. You saw what he said. He's threatening me and all this bullshit. I don't end up going off the air. If you want me to do it, I'll have to upload the show because I actually took it off Spreaker. I'm getting bombarded with Skype chats. Y'all should be glad that I don't have the message from so-and-so. So, I mean, I thought that what Snoozy put on his show was ridiculous. I thought it was sad. I think he proved again what he was. Who he is, and I was wrong about him, and I don't want to hate him. I don't want to dislike him. I think he's adorable, and I think there's just something about him that's cute, but I think he's just one of those people that's got me fooled or something. You know what I mean? I just believe that. Let me take a quick chat room shout out. I'm sorry. All right, you're right. You're right. You're right. You're right. You're right. You're right. DJ Bad Guy, Mr. White's in there. Mr. White is fucking awesome. I mean, awesome. He's a fucking asshole is what he is. Joe Spreaker, you rock. You fucking rock. You're a badass in my book. I don't know who Reds is, but okay. Yeah, welcome to you too. And News Guy, Debbie just sounds so catty. Boys don't say the word catty. Boys don't say the word catty. And don't say mean things. Angry Bong, you are an angel. Oro Shango, you are one of my best friends in life and even real life. I've met you offline several times. You're just such a badass. Everybody's in there. Say hi to everybody. Guy, bye. I'm going to hang up now. And I'll try to upload the show. So I got other things to do. Yeah, really. What a shitty fucking thing to do, Peter. That's horrible. That was really horrible. Schwans. Schwan's. Hey, Schwan's is nice, but it's expensive as fuck. I mean, Heather, when she moved into her first apartment, hold on just a second. When she moved into her first apartment, she would come over when she knew the Schwan's guy was there. And she'd go, yes, we need some. And I mean to tell you something, babies, if you want some food, get Schwan's. But Heather would order all this fucking food from Schwan's for her. And I'd get a bill that was $500, and I'd just write a check, and then half of it would be delivered over to her place. And I'd go, Heather, Michelle. She'd go, well, Mommy, I like Schwan's. Anyway, I just saw DJ Bad Guy wrote that in the chat room. DJ Bad Guy, you rock like a fucking hurricane. You and your buddy, even though he's weird as fuck, Sonny. I love Sonny. Sonny calls during the news guy show. Get out of that chat room. Get out of the chat room. So I'm going to go hang up and I guess come back with a... come back with an Andy Bong show and help him out with that. I'm going to go ahead and disconnect this one on the DJ console, but I've got to do a couple of things first for a friend of mine, and I'll be back when I get back. I'll be back in 15. It's 7:17 Central Standard Time. I'll be back by about 7:30. Okay? That's it. DJ Bad Guy, you rock fucking ass. And so does Joe Seeker, you do. And so do you, Mr. White. Mr. White's an asshole. He really is. Y'all think he's this nice, sweetie, tootsie guy. He's really... All right, I'm hanging up. I got to go. I'm getting yelled at. Bye. Goodbye. I'm hanging up.